Hey guys, welcome to another episode of the Boss TV Show. It has been a minute. How are you guys? I have genuinely missed you. I'm so glad to be back for now, but I'm so glad to be back. How are you?
Yeah, I'm glad you're back on set, but Dami, please talk through.
What?
Which man has been keeping you off the set? You just came back and you're going out like this.
We're single, ready to mingle. No, I'm joking.
It's not a man.
It's been like work and family. It's been taking a lot of my time. But I'm back because I missed you guys so much.
Same old.
I wore yellow today. That's a plus. That shows
definitely.
That I love you guys. Because I normally don't wear with yellow. But look at us.
We're glowing. You're bringing the heat to the screen. Definitely. And Dami also has a hot movie for you on the other side. Press play, you know how she does it. So,
as always, looking forward, man. And you've got a video that's coming up as well. Guys, you cannot go anywhere. And we have an amazing, amazing interview with a very, in fact, the guy is a star. And he's like super sexy. So, you can't go anywhere.
Don't go anywhere. So, enjoy new beats and we'll catch you on the other side. Hey guys, welcome back. That was Molo by LAX, man. Great video.
Okay, first of all, I have to ask. So is he as sexy in person?
Yeah, LAX, man. Still there looking for Carol.
But anyway. My name is Carol.
The guy is super cool. We're just kicking back. We talked about a lot of stuff.
Yeah. Okay, so what was it about him that, apart from him being like super cool and stuff, what was the one thing that you really liked that people should look forward to? By the way, he's coming after the break, so you can't go anywhere.
I mean, it kind of like threw me off because, I mean, I just wanted to talk about music because the last time he came on the show, we were kind of like talking about what he likes in women and all that kind of stuff. He kind of like took me off by telling me about this new campaign on drug. That is a serious issue in Nigeria at the moment.
Yeah.
You know, the codeine thing. So he decided to get on board.
I'm actually quite looking forward to hearing that.
Yeah, that was great though. I didn't see that coming from LAX. So he thinks it's a big issue and he just decided to address it.
No, that's definite. Like, because people are dying. Like, they're selling fake drugs. That's a huge problem.
I didn't know it was that bad though.
It is. But I'm really glad. See? Can you see why I told you he's like a sexy human being? Like, honestly.
He is sexy.
Anyway, guys, we are on to our first news. Now, we've got Jonathan, and he's going to be talking to us about an amazing photographer who's broken ground in the British magazine industry. You cannot go anywhere. This is actually quite cool.
Oh, wow. Hey, Jonathan, welcome.
Hello. How you doing, man? It's been a while, hasn't it?
Wow, yeah.
It's like you look really lucky. Some time, man.
You need to hook me up with those. I'm sad.
No, guys, the shoes are so dope. We don't have shoe cam, unfortunately.
Oh, wow, man.
Quite cool. Nice. So, Jonathan, you've got some information for us about an amazing photographer breaking ground. So, over to you.
Yes. So, we have the Jamaican and Nigerian fashion portrait photographer, Nadine Ajire, who she shot for Rihanna in the past, and she's done Vogue in Italy, Vogue in Ukraine.
Yeah.
Now, it's a big milestone for her in any photographer's career when you manage to shoot the cover of British Vogue. The exposure that she's now going to be getting from this is going to be amazing. So this is like, things like this can make someone's career really blow.
So she's already done it.
Yeah, she's already done that. That is amazing. She's done it in January.
Nice.
And she shot Dua Lipa, who's a singer-songwriter from the UK as well. It's a very big thing for her, and for Vogue as well, because they're following their American counterparts in the American Vogue, who had Tyler Mitchell, who he shot for Beyonce in August, and he was also the first black person in 126 years
in America. And how about in the UK?
It's 102 years.
Wow.
So it's taking quite some time for us to dabble and get into.
But we're there now.
But we're there now.
You said she shot the cover for Vogue in Ukraine as well.
Yeah.
And come on, that's a big slap on the Vogue UK. Yeah. She's actually based in the UK.
Yeah. Yes,
exactly. Very
that's
much,
good.
Jonathan.
I love that. Thank you so much, Jonathan. You, when are you going to pick up camera?
No, I think I'm very comfortable in front of it. Yeah, we'll leave that there. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jonathan. Maybe try some weight lifting between me and you. No one wants to be you. Looked at your past, even you know it's true. Look at that baby face. Hey, Toni, how are you?
Hey.
Good, how are you both?
I'm good.
I'm
good.
Super cool, super you know what I'm amazing. Saying? You're looking fantastic.
Oh, I know. Thank you. But I'm feeling a little left out.
Why?
I got the memo.
What?
You're bringing me sunshine.
I know. He was trying to copy me. I don't understand.
Yeah, I know. That would definitely make you feel better. Because we know the truth, right? It's all right, though. But you're looking smashing as well. I like the Christmas theme going on here.
Yes, no, you love look great. It. Like, speaking of fashion, like, you've got, like, amazing information in fashion industry in Britain. So over to you, my darling.
So coming up this week, we've got the Fashion Awards.
Yes.
Which are being hosted by the British Fashion Council alongside Swarovski.
Ooh.
And it's being held at the beautiful and iconic venue, the Royal Albert Hall.
Wow. Totally fancy, darling.
Oh, I'm feeling that, yes.
Very classy. Yeah. So this is an annual event celebrating individuals and businesses within the fashion industry who are smashing it, basically.
So is it just Britain, that is British fashion brands or whoever it is that wants to put themselves forward? What is it just?
So even though it's British Fashion Council and it's being held in London, they're also celebrating international influences. A vital role within the fashion industry here.
Yes.
Because it's so culturally diverse.
Nice.
Yeah, it's amazing. We've got over 2,000 judges.
Wow.
Picking the nominees and winners, so it's really big show.
To be fair, if they're opening it international, they need a lot of people to try and vet and go through and like obviously try and sort it out. So obviously you said it can be anyone, so guys, like, you never know, put yourself forward.
I think it might be too late now.
What, maybe you think so?
Maybe next year. Yeah, definitely.
Oh, they've already done the selection. Dang it, I wanted to put my name forward. Oh, and I was trying to encourage you guys. It's okay.
Oh my God. So yeah, I hope you'll be there to bring us all the lowdown on the event, right?
Yeah.
Well, I don't actually have tickets, but maybe next year.
Maybe next year.
Or even a press pass.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
The British Fashion Council are actually a non-profit organisation.
Nice, okay. And so how are they able to pull this off?
Well, in 2017, they raised £2.2 million.
So we see how they were able to pull this off.
So the Fashion Awards are actually a fundraising event as well to go to all of the work that the British Fashion Council do.
Nice.
All right, great.
So what they actually do is help support individuals, like educate them, give them mentoring and business support, and it's regardless of like what their financial circumstances or age, really. It's sort of from school age upwards.
Wow, that's really amazing.
So help a lot of people.
I love that. That's so brilliant.
Yeah.
Oh, I was going to get my sewing machine and I was getting excited trying to get you guys on board, and it's like we missed our window. Dang it.
So cool. That's really, really good and impressive as well.
Yeah.
All right, now moving on to another news, because I heard you have something else for us.
I have. So last week we were talking about the lovely Dalton Harris, who won the X Factor.
Yes.
But just a few days after winning, he had to be sent back to Jamaica.
Oh no!
He got forced to leave the UK because of his visa ran out.
Oh and no!
It was only granted for the show, so then he had to go back.
Wow, that's a bit... Wow, and he won. So what do you think is going to happen? Just hypothetical.
So he's gone back to try and get another visa. So he's hoping that because he's won, hopefully... Yeah.
They should give him a passport.
is that stretching it a little bit?
Oh, I should just put that in there.
He'll obviously get an amazing record deal.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they'll have to give him some sort of visa, surely.
But we'll see.
We'll see him back soon.
Wow. Yeah, definitely. I mean, he did very well for himself. I know Simon could put in a word or two to make him, you know, become a British national, right?
Yeah. You think so? Does he have that pulling power? Can I speak to him?
So, thank you so much, Toni, for your time.
Thank you.
It was very great to have you on set. You know, you did your thing, as always.
Yes.
Thank you.
Beautiful Toni.
Oh my God. See you soon.
See ya.
But Dami, you know, you always hook me up with the latest movies and
all that.
Yeah. Recently, I just signed up to Netflix and I've been trying to catch up on some.
You're not chilling or anything, no?
I see where you go. You bad, bad girl.
No.
So I've been catching up on a lot of movies that, you know, I couldn't watch like you so can. And Wedding Parties 1 and 2. I thought that was great. I've been watching a lot.
Okay.
And I'm really into it, but I think I'm not sure where to go to now. Well, so what would you recommend for me?
Honestly, there's so many movies, but the one I'm going to recommend now isn't actually out on Netflix, but you have to keep an eye out. So this one is from our motherland, Ghana, and I love it because it is very different. It's extremely poetic, and the narrator for this movie is Amake Abrase, and her voice is just...
It's, and then rings
it's,
a bell,
it's phenomenal. Yeah, she was in Beast of No Nation. She is a talented actress. So this movie, guys, is called The Burial of Kojo, and it's about a man who is vengefully trapped in a shaft by his really, really horrible brother, and his daughter goes on this magical journey to try and rescue him. It is brilliant. I just, the concept, hopefully you get it, because it's very short but quick but quite powerful. Guys, here's the trailer. I'll see you after the break.